Congratulations on your news. This is absolutely superb. It came on your birthday. Just share what that moment was like, finding out for the first time that you're having a child.
It was pure shock. Like, I can't explain it. I was half asleep, and I wasn't late, so I didn't know why I was doing the test. But it was my birthday, and I knew that there'd be copious amounts of champagne, so there's something in me that took the test, and I was just floored. I still can remember the moment, and I had grand plans to tell Benji in, like, cute little ways, and that all went out the window.
What did you do instead?
I showed him the stick, and he was asleep, and then I started crying, and he didn't quite connect the two. He thought something really bad had happened. And he just got up and washed his face, and he was in shock. And then when he came back, he was like, are you pregnant? Like, it was very strange. The whole thing was very
Isn't
surreal.
Funny? Sometimes you have these sort of dreams, and you imagine how things will play out, and reality is always so different. This is a sign from your late mum, Zoe.
Yeah, we were incredibly close, and she had me when she was 32, and I always had this thing that I would fall pregnant when I was 32, and it was my 33rd birthday, and there was this weird feeling of, like, is this going to happen? And coming up to that point was, like, my mum was 32, and I was going to be 32, and then when I found out on my birthday, and I was obviously pregnant before I was 33, it was this weird synchronicity, and it was a kind of a nice little, I don't know, like a sign, I guess.
Mm. Well, for years you were trying to have a baby. You had a special diet, Chinese herbs. Did this genuinely, in your mind, help you conceive?
100%. I know it's radical and it's drastic and controversial, but the way that my body was prior to doing this cleanse and then how it was after,
what actually did you do? What was the regimen that you went through?
Oh, so what you do for the first 2 weeks is you don't eat any food and you take just herbal supplements, so just Chinese herbs. You're under the watch of a doctor, obviously. You have daily acupuncture, massage, cupping. It's very, very difficult. It's very hard. And because your organs are regenerating, what happens is when you stop eating, the cells can go to the places in your body that have been diseased or had scar tissue or whatever. So my endometriosis actually came back to the forefront, and I had to feel all the bad stuff while it rehealed, and then it went. And I can tell you that I had no endometriosis symptoms after I did that. So falling pregnant within 2 months of that was, I have to say, it was that. I mean, there's some other stuff Benji's involved in, but apart from that,
small. It's pretty hard to argue when you see how sudden the result was. Do you know what you have in Zoe?
I don't.
Are you going
to? I don't know if I can hold on. You know, it's. I hear it's the best surprise if you can actually wait. Yeah. I don't know. Benji doesn't want to know. If I know, how am I not going to tell him? We've got to figure that out.
You are such a blabbermouth that you won't. If you don't want to know, I don't think you better find out at all. As is often the case, when something happens in your life, a million things happen. So now you've just had this wonderful news with the baby, and there's the new show, The House of Wellness. So what's the best thing about that show?
Do you know the weirdest thing was these two things happened in 24 hours. So I found out I got the show, and then I found out the next day that I was pregnant. And that was like, oh, that's amazing, and how are we going to manage that? And it's in Sydney and I'm in Brisbane, and we had all of those questions. But I think being a wellness show, and I had just gone through being the most well I'd ever been, and looking at, you know, alternative ways and traditional ways of being healthy, I was living the message. So I'm really passionate about the show.
Now tell us, you're wearing a shirt there today. It's
Can
part of a new fashion project. Tell us about it.
I am not worldwide.
Yeah, so I mean, I didn't have enough on my plate, so I thought, why not collaborate with Dish Boutique? So the founder, Lucy, and I have made Ruled by None. It's an empowering women's clothing line, and we've dropped our t-shirts first. So they've got